This is my new QHY miniCAM mono camera, and I must tell you that there is so much to love about this little camera. In this video review, I'll tell you everything about why I love this camera. It has become my all-in-one solution for astrophotography. It is filled to the brim with great features, is compact yet high-performing, relatively inexpensive but not so low quality, and has a great design that is far from simplistic. First up, let's talk about its key features. This is a cooled camera, so this camera uses an integrated cooling system. It uses a dual stage TE cooling system, which is highly efficient. As you might be aware, the reason we use cooling system is to reduce thermal noise and allow for long exposure times without compromising image quality. Well, I've been using this camera for some time now, and I can say that the cooling system hasn't missed a beat. It can go minus 45 degrees Celsius below ambient temperature, which is remarkable. It's quick and spot on. There is one little problem though, which I will get to at the end of the video. In terms of its sensor, the miniCAM uses a highly sensitive Sony IMX585 CMOS sensor. This sensor is well tried and tested and is one of the most reputable sensors in the astrophotography world. This sensor is very sensitive, especially in the near-infrared spectrum. It produces excellent image quality with a peak quantum efficiency of 92%. A high QE ratio means that even faint objects are captured with great detail and clarity. Its full well capacity is 54 KE, which provides a good dynamic range. Another good selling point of this sensor is that it produces a very low readout noise. The readout noise as low as 0.76E, this ensures that the images captured are clean and free from electronic noise. Also, this sensor has a pixel size of 2.9, which provides a good balance between resolution and sensitivity. Small pixels can capture finer details. Not only does it have a good cooling mechanism and high quality sensor, but it also has a filter wheel inbuilt into it. This camera is an all-in-one solution. That means you don't have to purchase filter wheels and filters separately. They come in the package. The built-in filter wheel is an 8-position filter wheel. I have luminance, red, green, blue filters, as well as H-alpha, oxygen, and sulfur. These filters are unmounted, 1.25 inches. The SHO filters are 7nm, which is fine. But you have to assemble the filter wheel yourself. It doesn't come plug and play, so you have to do some work yourself. This filter wheel can be easily controlled with softwares like Nina. The filter wheel and the filters are precise as well. The filter wheel is designed to position filters accurately, ensuring that each filter is perfectly aligned with the sensor. This precision is crucial for maintaining image quality and avoiding artifacts that come from misaligned filters. The filter wheel is controlled by the same USB cable, so you don't have to have three different cables controlling three different things, just one cable. In terms of connectivity, it uses fast USB 3.0. All the drivers required are provided on the QHY website and they seem to work just fine. Currently, they are in beta mode though, as the camera is still new, but they seem to work fine. As mentioned earlier, it supports all the major softwares. I use Nina with it and it has been working great. In terms of powering the camera requires 12 volts DC power supply. The power consumption of the camera is approximately 24 watts. What about the build quality and ergonomics? Well, this camera weighs around 480 grams, which in my books is reasonably lightweight. So balancing the mount is not going to be too difficult. In terms of its build quality, material used seem high quality and robust. It shouldn't have any problems withstanding the rigors of outdoor use, including exposure to different temperatures and humidity levels. It also has anti-dew technology built in, which prevents condensation on the sensor and optical window. What about its price? Well, I purchased it from Cyclop Optics and it costed about $834, which is super cheap when you think about the value you get from this. I mean, the filter wheel, the filters, the camera, and all of that, I think it's a good value. Here's an image I recently took with it. Now let's talk about some things that I don't like about this camera. Well, first of all, the software is still being developed. You can see that when you plug the camera in with the power adapter, as soon as you plug it in, it goes full speed to reduce temperature, even though it has received no such command or instruction from you. That can be very annoying. I mean, I want to be able to control the camera myself. I don't want it to go full blazing on me without me even asking. I suspect this will be resolved when the drivers are updated. Another big potential disadvantage of this camera is that you are stuck with the same filter wheel and filters forever. Now, perhaps QHY will roll out new unmounted filters for these cameras, but you're kind of stuck with what they offer. Filters that you already own are not compatible with this. Also, what if the filter wheel gives up its ghost? Then this camera is essentially useless. Having said all of this, the quality of the camera is good, so I don't expect it to give up its ghost anytime soon. Overall, I really love this camera. I love this all-in-one compact design. It produces excellent images, and I look forward to capturing more images with it. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, please feel free to write them below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Clear skies.